Alright guys, this is going to be a real quick mini-sode. I'm just going to show you the new lug nuts once I get these things installed. So I just want to show you a real close-up out of the old ones and how they're covered in spots and you can't see too well. This one's really bad. See that? They all look like that, okay? They're all grimy and of course the lock nuts are all screwed up like they've always been, right? I'll just show you one more sample here. Yeah, they're totally scraped up from all those lug nuts and stuff like that. See? So I'm gonna go ahead and put on all those brand newies. I'm gonna do it out here, one side at a time. I'll just show you a final result. I'm not gonna show you me screwing on lug nuts. Whoopee. As usual, my project seemed to expand. I might as well do the rear of my barrels while I have the wheels off so conveniently. So I put down my rubber Craftsman mat, and unlike someone recently in a video, I forget, that scratched up the rim because it fell down. You always use your rubber mat when you're cleaning the backs of your rims here. So, oh, there's my vinyl. See how that's holding up? I don't want to take it off because I'll probably just wreck it. And if I do peel it off, I'll be running with blue and I'll hate it, so I might as well just not touch it. That's the best idea there. What about yellow tint over the wheel caps? Probably look like crap, but it could be interesting. I'll show you my wheel cap anyway, just because it's pretty dang rare that I have it out, but like I've never had it out. And you can see it's still really good condition. You can even see how really good condition the edges are. And then of course you just tuck it and squeeze to get it to seal tight around there. But I mean, overall the edges and the front are very good. I could probably polish off those little watermarks if I wanted to. And you can see yourself in there. That's a pretty nice little vinyl wheel cap right there. See, this is no optical illusion. I'm looking at myself in my wheel cap. Huh, interesting. I got some ideas, but I hate to do yellow. It's just gonna, it's gonna mix with the blue on the Subaru and probably give me a green. I don't know, I'm just kinda wanting to spice things up, maybe with the wheel caps. Anyway, I can do that some other time, I guess. Maybe, I'm gonna leave the wheel caps off while I think about it, because this is the only time you can get the wheel caps off. When the wheels are off, don't even try prying them from the outside. You're gonna scratch everything up. So since I have them out, I'm going to leave all my wheel caps out. I can pop them in anytime I want. And I'm just gonna mull over, what can I do with the wheel caps aside from stock? My dream is to have the stock, so hot. To have the stock wheel cap, except black logo instead of blue. Not fully blacked out like this. And I've never seen them or else I'd own them. So I don't know if someone knows where they do have those. Just like mine, except the black instead of the blue. That would be ideal. Hey, if you guys haven't signed up for the double extra large t-shirt contest, t-shirt giveaway for the Last Human Garage Fat Body, what else did they say? USA t-shirts. You got one more day to enter, maybe a half day to enter. Just find that video two or three back and you'll find the link, or you can find the link on my Facebook videos page. Only like 170 entries, and each person probably puts in three, so that's really only 50 to 60 people that have entered. That's pretty good odds compared to most contests you're gonna enter. And there's two shirts available, so there's gonna be two winners. So even if you don't fit a 2XL, I mean, it doesn't matter to me how many people sign up, it's just for your own good. You know, maybe you can order it for a friend or something, see if you can win it. So, I'll see you guys. Hopefully someone wins it that really needs it. I guess that'll have to do. I mean, this isn't a show car, and I've scrubbed them really hard with a brush, and I mean, I can't get off everything, But hey, that's, even I went down deep here, that's pretty dang nice, isn't it? This stuff is like, I don't know, permanent. I'm not gonna take sandpaper or nothing to that. So overall, I mean, I don't wanna, dang. They're just gonna get dirty again so quick, you know. I'll just, you know, stir up some of the holes, and then that's about it. And I'll have to put them back, because I don't wanna be here 3 hours washing these wheels. This is one cool little part I like to do. You can see all the dirt here for the lug nut part. And you can really, at least you can get that nice and clean. That looks pretty good now, see? You got all this dirt build up. And you can just, it's an easy part, overlooked a lot of times. And clean the inside of those puppies. Real nice, real nice. That's the least I can do. Just an interesting note that the new lug nuts are different design than the old ones, which I couldn't care less, you know. They're the exact same length and thread, which is all that matters, but they're a different design. I kind of like the more long ones, the new ones, rather than those stubbies with a lot of circle on top. It was harder to clean. So anyway, the new ones look pretty good, but I'm just saying, you might get a variety of different styles from that link, that eBay link. I'll put it in this video. I've put it in other videos. I'm not going to make nothing off it, but just in case you want to look at those black lug nuts. Until I can order that nice, safe lug nut wrench for the lugs, you know, the one that doesn't scratch, I'll just do a poor man's workaround. I'll take a glove and just tuck it in there nice and thin, just to protect that finish a little as I do the tightening. Now the problem is, the first time you go to a shop, they're going to take a gun to it and they're all toast. So that's the problem there, but you know, as long as I don't take it to a shop and have them touch my car, I'll be all right. Major problem on those lugs, guys. So, the stock lug is 12 by 1.25, whether or not you can see that or not. 12 by 1.25. These things were just weird. They were wobbling. I'm all, what the hell? Why isn't this tightening right? And then I took a real close inspection of the new lug nuts, and they are 1/2 inch-20. These are American lug nuts. Now, of course, I'm gonna go to my order and find out what happened. Either I ordered 1/2 inch by 20 and didn't pay attention, or they sent the wrong ones. The auction that I ordered was a Subaru tiled auction, FRS, not that, the BRZ, the whatever, the, all the Subaru stuff is what that auction was. It had to be metric. I'm thinking they made a mistake and sent me American lugs. Luckily, I didn't strip out anything because they're so close, they thread on. But that final tight was just too weird, and I knew something weird was going on. Started wobbling. I'm all, what the hell? So glad I caught it now before my wheels fell off. But I would have known, because it just wasn't reaching the torque like it was supposed to. So I'm going to check my auction, either get pissed at myself or get pissed at them, depending on who did what, and we'll go from there. I've got to put my stock nuts back on, damn it. And to finish up, without showing you too much here, the seller is setgroupusa.com. I ordered 12 by 125. I did not order 1/2 by 20. They sent the wrong ones. I'm about to call them up and bitch at them. I mean, send them a note.